5.5 number 41, we are going to integrate cotangent x. Well, derivative of what function will be cotangent x? It's much harder to think about it like that. It's easier whenever you are trying to work with like cotangent or tangent. Let's write the cotangent x in terms of sine and cosine. So, break this apart, we'll get the integral of cotangent x, it's the same as cosine x over sine x dx. I'm just going to transform the integral to this. And now, we can use the u-substitution. And we do have two choices for the u, namely the cosine x on the top or the sine x on the bottom. And the correct choice for u is going to be sine x. And let me show you why. Because to differentiate that, I will get derivative of sine x will be cosine x dx. Isolate the dx, I will get dx equals to du over cosine x. As you can see, the cosine x is on the bottom. That will cancel with this cosine x on the top in a minute. Alright, we can change this integral to the u world. Bring this to the u world. So on the top, I will still have the cosine x, but on the bottom, the sine x in the u world is just the same as u. And then dx, as we have worked out earlier, it's the same as du over cosine x. And as you can see that we can see the cancellation, cosine x right here, cancel with this cosine x right here, like this. Alright, try to have some fun now doing math with you guys. Anyways, this is the same as integral of 1 over u du. So the integral of this is ln u. But when you're doing things backwards, when you have the ln right here, you are going to attach an absolute value. Alright, this is ln, absolute value. U is sine x, let me plug this back in here, absolute value, I'm done, so I have the plus c right here, just like this.